Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode here on Pasticheofskin. Today we are checking out the PlayStation Plus freebies for the month of January 2017. And we've already gone through one video game, we're going to take a look at another, and we're going to keep on getting through these as fast as we can, so you guys can get an idea of what the quality is actually available on PlayStation Plus for each month here on the PlayStation Network. Today, we're going to look at This War of Mine, The Little Ones. Now, This War of Mine is dark, depressing, and I'm going to give it the somber respect that it should have. But at the same time, is if I start to feel a little bit too sad, I'm not going to. I'm going to just start making jokes and commenting and doing horrible shit. So if you're heavily offended by the entire concept of somebody actually making light of war and violence, death, pestilence, and robbery, as well as the death of children, I'm sorry. But it's a video game. Can we not get too upset about this? Please? Now let's take a look at This War of Mine. This War of Mine, The Little Ones, is an expansion to This War of Mine, where it has included children. Now, I don't know if you're actually taking the perspective of a child surviving through a war zone, or it's just the fact that there are children added to it. I have never played This War of Mine. I've just seen other people playing it, and I've seen the kind of emotional effect it can have on people playing them, as well as the general tone of the game being quite dark. Now, this is like the zombie survival game without the zombies, which is the most interesting and coolest part of the whole the whole concept of it. And I don't know if this is one of those games that should be in like the top games of the year, but it definitely is on the same level as like Spec Ops The Line and stuff, for actually educating people about the horrors of the real world around us and the shit that we ignore every single day. So it's an important game, if not an amazing game. Let's see what it's actually got for me to see in gameplay. Loading. Yeah, exactly what I think. Fuck the war! So, what have we got here? We got survive, and then we got the settings. I might take a wee quick look at the settings here, just to make sure everything's set to the right. Softer sketching, heaven, Celsius or Fahrenheit? I think I'm going to stick with Celsius. Oh, Portuguese, Espanol, Italiano. I'll just go with default, because that default matches it to whatever my console actually is. This is controls, I'll be able to figure that out as I go. Let's just survive. I'm assuming there's actually more modes or something that are unlocked as you complete through it and repeat it over and over again. But this is, of course, the first time to try and survive war. I wonder if I should have practiced this beforehand so I don't die immediately, but we'll see what happens. Day one. The war begins. My family is lost. I have nowhere to stay. This place seems to be a good place to bed down for the night, at least. Not that really that much left to do other than just wait. See if this war is coming home to roost. I didn't think of ad-libbing while I was going along there. So we have people inside the house. We obviously have the house itself. I don't know what any of it means. When the Civil War broke out, many people thought it would only last a couple of weeks. It's been years since government military surrounded the rebels in the capital, cutting off all supply lines. Civilian population trapped in the city are suffering from hunger, disease, and shelling. Katya met both Pavel and Bruno before the war. She used to be a reporter, while Bruno had his own television cooking show. Pavla was the star of the local football team. Katya even interviewed him once. Now they meet in a dramatically different circumstances, looking for food and shelter. Okay, wait, so I'm playing as Katya? Okay, are things, I don't, some things get shelter as one, okay. So I need to go and do stuff here. So what is in here? Oh, how long I can take to make things? Alright, a simple heater would be very important. I need to get certain things to do that. Alright, so what do I do to get stuff? Is this me gathering materials? All right, so I can do multiple things with multiple people. Yeah, you get off your fucking ass, man. Herbs. Okay. Materials. Grab all. Yeah, take everything. And you go down there. Take a look in here, see what we got. It's locked. Alright, we need to find a way in there. We didn't really have that much to take, but we'll grab all that we can. Wow, she has a lot of digging to do. Well, if we take all that stuff, that's going to be pretty useful. Let you get you to go... you go looking in there. Alright, so in the first day, I essentially imagine that we need to get everything we can out of the space and get ourselves ready and prepared. Whoa, you got a lot of running to do. So you can only get one person at a time into that. Let him work away at that. Nicely done, girl! He's digging. He's got that door open already. Happy days. This is actually kind of like, it feels like a bit of a crafty gathering thing that I'm actually enjoying here. No idea if I should be harvesting all this stuff. I don't know if I'm meant to stay in this house or if I'm going to die here, but I'm trying to use what I have of my first day here to grab absolutely everything I might need and then maybe get whoever's carrying the most stuff to actually bring it all back. There's nothing here otherwise, so I can go back through here. I might leave her to actually do this job here. He's doing that. He's doing that. This one's nearly done, though. Happy days. So imagine they might actually individually have different stats, or they're actually, if they're sharing space or sharing everything together, that'd be kind of cool and useful. So it's kind of mad seeing that explosions going off in the background as well. Oh, needs to actually break that barricade down. More herbs, take all, take all. Is there actually a balcony out there to go to? No, there isn't. Right. I need to actually go through here and hit down. There we go. Anything out the front of the house? Okay, so at least in the first day, I'm not going anywhere. Just the fact that I was curious to find out. Can I break through that door? Is there a way to do it? Because I need tools to open the door. Is that? Improvement? Enable the manufacture of more sophisticated items. Well, should I go for the upgrade immediately? I think I might actually grab some basic amenities first, because, I mean, if I have... So if I have a simple heater... Yeah, so if I have a simple heater, I can make that... Okay, so the heater needs to be somewhere convenient. I'm thinking this might be the best place to put the heater. Yeah, he's done and dusted there. So I can do this. That one's locked as well. Okay. So I think the next thing I need to worry about is lockpicks to clear out the rest of the stuff that's here in the house. If there's any way to build those. So I think those are like essentially the next kind of tools I need to build. A metal workshop would be useful. Let's put that down here into the corner. And go to you. What have you got to do? Yeah, close that. And what's this? Too bad it isn't cooked. Oh god, no, that's actually, I need to build a stove. Crude stove. That'll do the job. Put you in the kitchen. I did not mean to put her in the kitchen. I meant to put the stove in the kitchen. Just if anybody's curious, that was not meant to be offensive in any way, shape, or form. Crowbar? There you go. So you can make bits and pieces, but you need to have things to do that. A lockpick I need. What do I need? Well, whatever it is, I don't have it. But, the simple heater. Oh, god, no, it's actually, you need to make fuel. So, work away at that. You, sir. Need to get downstairs somehow in a way. I think. Actually, do you know what you need to do? You need to build. I need to build some kind of bed. Some kind of bedding. I need, in fact, three of those. Oh, I don't have any materials for it. Oh, god, have I used up all the important stuff already? Oh, man, that's not cool. I don't think I should go on with the metal workshop, should I? Ah, crap. What do I do whenever I don't have... Damn. So, what can I do? At least there'll be cooked food. So I'm gonna let one of these guys take a dander out. Oh, the night? No. Oh god, it became night. Do I go far away? So I've got shelter here. So where do I go? Oh wow. What does that say? Sleep. Guard scavenge. So he can go scavenge. Oh no, to be honest, I think he should scavenge. He should sleep. She should sleep. Yeah, I think that'd be the best way to do it. And I'd go as far as the abandoned cottage. What should I take with me? Okay. I'm going to take two herbs. And I don't really need to take anything else, do I? Really, do I? Yeah, go scavenging with the herbs. Just so that I actually have someone if I need to heal up somebody. So if somebody's feeling sick or they're saying, if you got any herbs, I can actually give them something. Ooh, what's here? That's a sniper? Ah, that's not a good sign. Looting, looting, looting. Grab all. Grab everything you can. Ooh, okay. So, what is this? These are all materials, just wood. But I can only carry two of them at a time? Alright. I don't know if I need gunpowder just yet. Right. Let's see if I can go up here and help somebody out, because it looks like I can hear somebody. What's that? Just curious to find out. Family photo of parents and two daughters. Good thing the girls don't resemble their father. He looks like a bear. The first day they robbed us, 2 days later they murdered our girls. Shot every one of them, but I don't want to use the gun anymore. It's broken and buried in the backyard. Ooh. So I think I actually need to come back here with everybody, because this needs to be properly cleared out. Let's get our asses out of here. So I'm going to take everything that I have and drop it off for the night, because that should be enough wood and bits and pieces to make a bed. This works pretty reasonably well. I've got this now. I think I've got the basic pattern, and it's a matter of surviving. I'm just going to go back to that same place. I'm just going to strip mine places as I go along, although admittedly I don't have any weapons yet, so this could be interesting if anybody attacks.
Day 2.
Hey guys, I'm back. Cool. And I'm going to make a bed. That's exactly what I'm going to do. I think we need to actually make rainwater. So I need more components for that. Not a good sign. What do you need to do? Lockpick, shovel. So that's for getting through rubble quicker. But 4-7 doesn't use anything, so we need 7 of 12. 3 of 12. So we'll get a shovel. Right, it says I'm using the wood for that, but I can use components for that as well. Do I need to actually, and do I need to build any more fire, or have we got enough? That's the question. While he's working away at that, I am going to go for a wander and get the rest of the stuff from that house. That sounds like a plan. Oh, can I only do that at night? Right, okay. Interesting. So we've already cleared out the house, except for the things that are locked away. That's not a good sign. Yeah, at least it's warm. That's a good thing. At least we did get a space heater in. I might just let her sit and chill, because I mean, there's not much else I can really do until it gets to nighttime. I'm going to let him work away and make some knockpicks. Yep, you chill out in your chair, dear. So there's one up there. Actually, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get this door down here at the bottom. It gives me more space and there's more things to actually get rid of. Yeah, sleeping on the floor is terrible. Completely understand that. Let's get ourselves in through this door at least. Oh, it's on the dig. And he has a shovel! I'm glad I thought that through. Oh, God damn it! So we need more components and wood, and then we can get the improved workshop. Which is probably a good sign, a good choice. Can't make anything else here because I don't have any of the materials for it. Probably would have been useful to have the knife. I kind of wish I hadn't used my lockpick. Is there absolutely nothing else in here? No, nothing else. I think I need to end the day, really, at this point. Yep, sure, I want to end the day. So I'm just going to go to the night and then send everybody out to scavenge. Everybody scavenge. Does that actually, just checking to see if it actually says what they have. Because I can barely read that on my screen. It's just because the text is so small. Oh god, that's not being helpful in any way, shape, or form. Fast runner. Bargaining skills. Well. Shelled school. Ooh. Alright, let's get ourselves into the abandoned place first. I'm going to take the shovel with me, and I don't really need anything else, so let's go and scavenge! So I'm going to get the gun from the backyard, that's the plan. There's more stuff here that I didn't even know was there in the first place. Make my way to the backyard first. And get through to that. Keep on digging, keep on digging. Are you kidding me? Ah! Right. Okay, strip mine in the house. Nothing there except for his letter. Right, so I need to drop some stuff here. That's wood, 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 wood. Components, components, components. Shovel, vegetables, and drop the... Got a stove to cook with, so I can actually... Grab that, I'll take the water. Probably the most important. What's in here that's actually of value? Probably just be able to stack them if there's anything important. Yeah, I can take more of those. Parts, wood, gunpowder. So is there anything I can afford to drop here? Not really, is there? I could take one more wood, wasn't it? Can I go down? I'll go down here. Essentially, I'm just taking all the components and everything I can get my hands on. So I need to be able to make as many lockpicks as possible. That's the important thing. Because the lockpicks are what are letting me get into the rest of the stuff. Again, it's all wood. All right. Blades, barrels, okay. That's weapon parts. So if I drop two of these, I'll come back for this. I mean, I'm sure I'll regret not taking a weapon immediately, but... Oh, man. It's just the fact that immediately I'm thinking of what are the important things. Food. Essentially, food... Water and crafting supplies. We've been raided? Oh man! What'd they take? Someone tried to rob us, they might have been more scared than us, so they didn't do much harm. We had no weapons, Pavel and Bro. We're wounded? Oh, man. No, no, you fuckers. So they took some of the herbs. Got slightly wounded. Bruno got slightly wounded. You fuckers. Ah. Right, that's it. Weapons are new. Like, that's it. I was going to be polite and shit, but no, that means that we need to actually build weapons now. That's really shitty. Oh, and I need the parts to do that. God damn it. That's really shitty. We need to make something that we can actually use to kill people. It's a mean thing to say, but we need to actually find something that we can use to hurt people. Yeah, electronic components, it's going to take a lot of those to do that. Made to make fuel. Yeah. So at least I can use one of the lockpicks and actually get into here and then get into the other one. Hey, that's what we needed. And another lockpick as well out of that. Happy days. And books. What do books do? and you make them feel if the worst comes it. That's convenient. Trying to figure out where I need to go down to the basement, isn't it, for the last few bits and pieces. Yep, come down you go. So, yeah. Essentially, now that we're healed, at least, I can actually manage him up for any injuries. And there's medicine as well! Yay, sugar. And books. Okay, so now we have enough... We actually literally have... We're at the point now where we have stuff that requires... actual kind of, like, defense. Because... Did she... not make enough picks? Yeah, it's locked. Can I not make more picks? Yeah, make lock picks. That's what I want you to do. And whenever you finish making that one, I'm going to immediately use it. So just pass it over to me here. Thank you. Oh, what does this guy have? Sweet. Awesome. This is kind of useful. So, he's got tinned food. He's got cigarettes. He's got coffee. Herbal meds. Herbs. Tobacco. Raw food. Quality roll-up. I wonder what kind of roll-up is that? Yeah, that's what I need. I need those. 84. What's that? Moonshine. Ooh. Books keeps people uplifted. Component parts would be useful as well. But what would you take for it? Shell casings? Oh, we didn't really need those, did we? But fermentation. How about we throw 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Alright. Anything else that I really want out of this? I'm essentially trying to break the habit of cigarettes and tobacco and shit. I've got plenty of food. I've got herbs. And I've got medical herbs as well. No, I just got herbs. I don't have any medical herbs. You have to show me a lot in exchange. Ammunition is quite common. Okay. Yeah, wood. Might as well. I can't take any more wood. Ha! Got too much wood. So what will he trade for it? Let's see. Will you take that? Will you take that? How about... don't want to give you electric parts. And you know what I'll do is I'll... drop the wood. I don't really need... There we go. We got a deal! And I still have some of my diamonds. Happy days! I got all the weapon parts I needed. That works for me. Making weapon. Yeah, someone was knocking. Alright, that's the house completely ransacked. Now it's a matter of getting all these weapons done. We need everybody to have a weapon. Back hurts from sleeping on the floor? Well, that means we need beds. Let's make some weapons. We're making weapons. We're making weapons that we can use to kill people. And it feels so good to have all things we need. Wow. What components we need? What are we missing? 36? Oh, wait. We need that many? Wow. Holy shit. How many do we have? Whoa. Shit. Where's the things I need to actually make? Ugh, that's annoying. Well, don't have that. At least I have lockpicks, so I'm going to be able to get into the place that I need to go to next time. And, yeah, do you know what I need to do? Well, say to you, guy, we don't need you to stick around anymore, so safe travels. Yeah, man. Safe travels. Nice meeting you. Birdie burper. I need to make sure to bandage him up. What is she doing? Are you going to go and sit down? Alright, you need to go down and get yourself bandaged up, chap. Got bandages, so we make use of them. Yes, you could, dear. You could use some rest. And what you're going to do is get your ass upstairs and get into that bed you just made. Well, the guy finished it off for you because you were too exhausted. And then you can watch guard tonight. It's opening and closing doors. That's all you're good for. Yep. So. You can guard. You can sleep in bed. And you scavenge. And this time you're going to the abandoned cottage. And you need to take 1, 2, 3 of those. You need to take that just in case. And that's about it. I'm going to take our medications. I'm going to take that. Should be enough for what I need. Guys, I'm actually really, really getting into this. I mean, for a survival game, normally I'm actually really uncomfortable with survival games. I always find them extremely difficult. They annoy the balls of me. This is not the case. This is actually... Why is he... Is he, like, got a passive sonar or something that is actually allowing him to see everything? Alright. I'm going to get this place completely scavenged this time. Oh, our already pockets are already filled. Right. Well, this time I can actually get into the room, and I'm pretty sure there's a guy in here. Coffee, homegrown tobacco, fertilizer, weapon parts. We can't take all of those. Electric parts, okay. That's another thing I wasn't even thinking about, because you have components, but then you have electric parts as well. We can drop a couple of wood, so we can have more healing items in the house. I'm not as concerned about gunpowder either. That out, and we'll see what else is in here. That should be pretty much this house completely cleared out. Oh, sweet. There was another thing to actually unlock as well. Ugh. Okay. What am I missing? Ammunition? Well, that might actually be useful. So we need to drop something for that. I imagine best bet is to drop the wood and pick up the ammo. Yep, sound good. Ah, it's a rodent that's actually there. I was wondering. Whereas not a player, sometimes the situation will force you to get into a fight. You can meet people who will also remember that you are not defenseless. Ah, target an attack. Ah! Alright. Anything else we need to tick? No, no, no. Alright. Well, that's us done and dusted for the night. Scavenging-wise, I think I've got enough parts now to actually have a weapon to leave at home and then to take as well, so got ammunition and all that kind of crack. It's enough to actually be able to go and search. I like this. So, yeah, this war of mine has got me immediately entranced. I can see why people loved the first one. This one is just as good. There's literally nothing that's kind of a... Oh, did anything happen while I was away? Oh, shit, yeah. Did he get his bandages? Because I can't even tell if he's actually peeled up. I need to be able to see the... It's one of those things where it's really hard to read that bottom right corner. Unless I'm actually sitting really close to the TV, I can't read that text. It's not brilliant. I mean, essentially because I can try and look at it from multiple screens and I can't read it on any of those, which is a massive frustration. So let's get ourselves downstairs here and get the... Surviving? Alright. We do kind of need that. I don't know if we really need radio, though. I'm going to get... Looking at this, is there anything I can do in here? Make another knife. Can't upgrade that, though. Need a lot more parts to be able to upgrade. Do you have enough to actually upgrade the house workshop? Don't even have enough for that, either. That wasn't smart. Maybe it's better I don't spend any money on that. Oh, I need to actually make fuel for this as well. What's up with her? Is she tired? Hello, neighbor. I live down the street and I've noticed you're living in this abandonment. I've got some news. There was a humanitarian airdrop last night. Most containers were confiscated by the rebels. I know about one they missed. I landed in no man's land, so it might be dangerous to get to. But under the cover of darkness, be able to me. I'll show you where it is if you'll help me carry supplies. Yeah, sure. I'll do that shit. Ah, so he runs off to do that. Fair play. Yeah. You do that, dear. Are you serious? Why are you ill? Trying to think of what else to do here. I need to make a second knife because I'm going to take one of them with me. Well, alright. So I made it to day 4 so far. I'm going to go and do this last thing with the guy at night. and hopefully not lose or die along the way. So maybe that'll be the last thing I'll do for this, like, showing or this playthrough. Have we got enough of those? Yeah, I've got plenty of that to actually make fuel with. But yeah, I'm going to skip on to the end of the day because there's not really much else I can do with these characters. And we'll see what happens at night. Ooh. Oh, shit. All right, so my dude's actually going to just run off. Great. So she can scavenge, he can guard, and I'm not going to go to the abandoned cottage. I'm going to go huge amounts of materials. I was trying to think here. Caution advised. Alright, let's go to there, the ruined villa. I don't know what we're going to need to bring with us, but we're probably going to need to bring that and that at least. And I don't have, it's a broken pistol, but I need to actually fix it. I don't have anything else I can take with me. Even have a knife? Yes, I do have a knife. Happy days. So I can take that with me and I'll be safe. That's rock and roll. Even though I'm using like three of my spaces, I'm going to use one of them to actually just be able to open. So I thought I was actually going to take my guy with with that dude and come back with stuff. But obviously it's kind of like an automated event, is it? Is there people in there? Oh, wow. I'll come back for you. Where are they going? I didn't mean to actually like scare you off, dude. It was definitely not my intent. Okay. So I'm raiding somebody's house now unintentionally. This is all private property, and I didn't want to steal anything. I just wanted to actually go. Oh, there we go. Whoa. Hey. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm dead. I'm dead. Well, that's what happened to Katia. I'm really sorry, Katia. I don't know what I was doing. I didn't mean to break in the first place. I just kind of opened the door and then didn't want them to panic whenever I was down there. I should have went outside. That's what I should have done. Okay, so that was a really depressing day for night. Oh, Katia. Why did I have to give a picture of you with closed eyes too? Oh. He brought that back while he was away. He was like, Katia, you really loved coffee. And that's depressing. And they'll never know too. Oh, no, they know. Oh. God damn. God damn you, game. Oh. Well, that was a mistake on my part. Don't go running into other people's houses. Top tip for this war of mine. Yeah, that's you learned. Oh, write my own story? That's amazing. That's pretty cool. Yeah, guys. Thank you very much for watching. This War of Mine has a lot of replayability, a lot of interesting content, iterations, and versionings of what's happening in it. I could see this being unbelievably fun narratively, but also it is tragic and terrifying in its own way. Make sure to check it out as part of the PlayStation Plus for this month. It is free for January 26, 2017. And yeah, crap. This is a game I wish I'd played way back and actually could get into, but at least now I know I can go and get some guides and find out exactly how I should really build out myself for safety. So yeah, go check it out. Get a hold of a copy of this, and I will look forward to seeing any of your comments or thoughts about how badly I played this. Like, what do you need to really, really start off properly in this game? Tell me that. Make sure to say it in the comments and underneath. And if you're a big fan of this game, tell me how badly I messed it up. So thank you very much for watching, guys. Of course, remember, you can hit the subscribe button up there. That'll allow you to actually be able to see everything as it comes out here on the channel. And of course, over here is other videos of me not sucking quite so bad. And I will see all you dudes in the next video. Bye.